When it comes to your makeup, do you have a difficult time finding the right foundation? Yes. Our resident beauty expert, Michelle Phillips, is here with some tips to help us find the right canvas for our makeup look. Welcome back.
Hey.
I feel like if you look closely, you can like tell I totally don't match right now. Like, I'm so paranoid. I don't think that I do a very good job.
We're under lights and things happen to our skin tone. And that's the thing, is a lot of us have a hard time finding foundation because we're looking for that coverage, but we want it to look natural. And we don't want to look like, you know, your face and your neck don't match,
which like
you match, you're good. So, but it's difficult to do. So what I always start with, though, is good skincare. Because when you have really good skin, you don't have to cover as much. So really focus on that. And then also every single day, if you're not going to wear foundation, at least leave the house with wearing like a tinted moisturizer. It'll actually make you feel like you look better because it evens out skin tone. Many of the tinted moisturizers not only moisturize your skin, they protect with an SPF. They have a blurring effect, which helps minimize pore size, helps soften fine lines and wrinkles, tone and texture. So I wear this every single day, even when I'm gonna go work out. So it protects the skin. It's not damaging the skin at all.
Here's my thing with tinted moisturizers, though. And I have this with foundations as well. When I'm like standing in the aisle, you know, at the drugstore, I don't know where to go, what to match. Do you have to worry about it as much with tinted moisturizer, or
no,
is that a little more forgiving?
It is a lot more forgiving. Okay. It tends to just blend in to the skin a lot easier, and they usually come in a light, medium dark to dark. So look for something that you think would be in your range. And don't forget, you can return makeup, but it is good to try on before you leave the store if possible. And we'll talk about that in a minute, too. And the next thing is define your formula. So if you're not going to wear a tinted moisturizer every day, which, by the way, I have a tinted moisturizer on, and then what I do is I take a little bit of liquid and I just cover where I need to spot conceal rather than wearing it all over. In the summer heat here, to me, it's just too much. However, you know, it's always good to get a good primer. So if you're not going to wear a tinted moisturizer, a primer is really good to reduce the pore size and all of the wonderful benefits.
Oiliness, that's what I always battle.
It is. And then you want to look at, okay, do I want something like more of a sheer coverage, a medium coverage, and then you have your cream foundations, which are a little bit heavier coverage. So I always talk about having a wardrobe of foundation. You might want to have one of each depending on what the occasion is.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I definitely, what I wear on air for my job every day is definitely different than what I'm doing at night or on the weekend.
Yeah, exactly. So, of course, the light to medium and the cream coverage, you want to make sure you have two or three shades for each foundation that you wear more often. So the reason I say that is that you get a little sun exposure and your skin gets a little bit darker. You might want to blend a little bit of the darker shade with the lighter shade, so that way you get
that perfect. I'm blending right now, as a matter of fact.
And then the last thing, powder foundations are very popular too, but I apply them with a brush just to kind of give you a nice glow, a nice finish, so that's an option too. But really the most important thing is to try these on your cheek and your neck area and go outside in natural light before you leave the store to
see. Well, what is the trick? Because I feel like when I go to the store and they're like, oh, let me match you. And of course, I wish I could have that at drugstores, which you can't.
Right.
But it's like, you want to get matched. Do the old hand. This used to be like a thing. We do this area right now.
No, don't use your hand or your wrist.
Don't do this.
No. Okay. Side of the cheek and your neck area is where you want to test the foundation. And you want it to just blend in. You don't want to see any difference in color. Now, a lot of times my neck is more red than my face. So really you want to try to match your face color, and then you can blend down into your neck area when you do your foundation.
I have no idea what that's about. When your neck gets red, doesn't match your face. I have no idea
She's
what that's
hot
about.
Lights. That's
right?
Totally normal here, but
it's normal and not
totally normal.
Trust me.
Yeah. So, but definitely test on the cheeks.
Thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate it as always. And how can people stay up to date with you and ask me
MichellePhillips.com, and I have a free beauty guide for anybody that's interested in more tips.
I need it.